Hello, bless, konnichiwa, and yobaseo. Will here of the POLIT'AI CHI, talking briefly and concisely about slideshow montage, the video highlights coming up. Your presence through watching is honored. Hi. So what can I say? I mean, the slideshow speaks for itself. But this is a cobbling together of the fans' reactions, plus we got some former players at the end. There's a reason for this, which will be explained, but so much of this going on. Pittsburgh's head coach talked about 100% team participation. Yeah, Villanueva played for a team. It's called the Academy at West Point. What a dumbass, I said that. And so you've got a bunch of fans getting all annoyed. You know, stop trying to justify a very weak position. This is what leads to, like, a prolonged engagement in Vietnam. That's the reason for the Pirates. Roll it.
Villanueva is a West Point grad, an Army Ranger who served three tours in Afghanistan and was awarded the Bronze Star for saving the lives of his buddies in combat. His jersey has now become the biggest NFL player item sold online. But his patriotic gesture was indirectly criticized by his head coach, Mike Tomlin.
I was looking for 100% participation. We're going to be respectful of our football team.
Villanueva, I love you, brother. God bless you. Thank you for standing. As far as the Steelers go, no more.
To show their support for Villanueva, some fans burned their Steelers stuff. Jim Haney, 55 years old, told us he's been a Steelers fan since he was born. But he was so offended by the Steelers hiding in the locker room that he kissed his team goodbye.
All right. Pretty sure that speaks for itself. I sort of cut dude there off at the end because it's kind of like, it's not sure what he's saying there. I'm sure your ignorance should be burning away and hopefully you become re-enlightened. When you were in school, you think your head coaches would have gotten away with, would have let you get away with this? Oh, but it's okay now that you're like multimillionaires. You guys better get your act together. You're pissing off a bunch of former cops and those of us who support police foundations. And a lot of us also happen to be former players, and or a lot of us also happen to be vets. You're packing the wrong horse here, dudes. Better pull it together.
In his only public appearance today, President Trump was focused on a new plan to direct some $200 million a year toward improving STEM education.
Greater access to STEM and computer science programs will ensure that our children can develop the skills they need to compete and to win in the workforce of tomorrow.
But on Twitter, the president was still railing against the weekend protests in the NFL, where some 200 players took a knee during the national anthem or linked arms in solidarity against the president. Many people booed the players who kneeled yesterday, which was a small percentage of total, President Trump wrote. These are fans who demand respect for our flag. It all started at a rally for Senator Luther Strange in Alabama on Friday. President Trump talking about American pride and respect for the flag.
Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now, out, he's fired.
The statement brought swift reaction from players and owners alike. Patriots owner Bob Kraft, a good friend of the president, said he was disappointed.
He has to take his ideas and go with what he wants. I think it's very disrespectful to our country.
Some people thought the president was fueling racial divisions with what he said on Friday. Patriots quarterback Tom Brady stood for the anthem with hand on heart, but linked arms with another player.
I certainly disagree with, you know, what he said and you know, thought it was just divisive.
President Trump insisted Brady and others have it wrong, tweeting, quote, the issue of kneeling has nothing to do with race. It's about respect for our country, flag, and national anthem. NFL must respect this. Press Secretary Sarah Sanders today said the president has no regrets about his initial comments, regardless of the reaction they provoked.
Did the president go too far in referring to these players as SOBs who should be fired?
I think that it's always appropriate for the president of the United States to defend our flag, to defend the national anthem, and to defend the men and women who fought and died to defend it.
The controversy spread over into other sports. LeBron James, no fan of President Trump, was sharply critical.
The thing that kind of frustrated me and pissed me off a little bit is the fact that he's now, he used sport. He used the sports platform to try to divide us.
NASCAR, on the other hand, appeared to agree with the president in principle, if not parlance, in a statement saying, quote, our respect for the national anthem has always been a hallmark of our pre-race events. Some NASCAR owners said they would fire any driver or crew member who didn't stand for the anthem.
Driver Dale Earnhardt Jr. broke with his team's owner, though, saying that all Americans are granted the right to peaceful protest. Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback Ben Roethlisberger now says he regrets not coming out onto the field for the playing of the national anthem yesterday and says, you can bet we're going to be there next Sunday. Brett?
John Roberts, live on the North Lawn. John, thanks. The president seems to have done what NFL management and union officials have been unable to do, bring the players and the owners together on the same side. Senior correspondent Eric Shawn has more from outside NFL headquarters in New York.
Even after taking a hard hit, NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell is protecting his players like an unmovable offensive line. Of the protests, he told Sports Illustrated, quote, they reflected the frustration, the disappointment of the players over the divisive rhetoric we heard. Roughly 200 kneeled or locked arms in solidarity during the Sunday games, out of a total of 1,696 players.
You don't like this country? Find another one.
It's their right to have something to say.
Several owners joined the protests on the field. Washington Redskins owner Daniel Snyder locked arms with his players. The Dallas Cowboys owner Jerry Jones has said the gridiron is not the place for protest.
That's not the place to do anything other than honor the flag and everybody that's given up a little part.
Three teams stayed off the sidelines during the national anthem, but one player prominently defied that. Pittsburgh Steelers offensive tackle Alejandro Villanueva, a war hero, stood at the players' tunnel with his hand over his heart. Villanueva is a West Point grad, an Army Ranger who served three tours in Afghanistan and was awarded the Bronze Star for saving the lives of his buddies in combat. His jersey has now become the biggest NFL player item sold online. But his patriotic gesture was indirectly criticized by his head coach, Mike Tomlin.
I was looking for 100% participation. We're going to be respectful of our football team.
Villanueva, I love you, brother. God bless you. Thank you for standing. As far as the Steelers go, no more.
To show their support for Villanueva, some fans burned their Steelers stuff. Jim Haney, 55 years old, told us he's been a Steelers fan since he was born, but he was so offended by the Steelers hiding in the locker room that he kissed his team goodbye.
This hung on my wall for years. Not anymore. In the fire.
People who benefited most from America despise it. And increasingly they do. Where does that leave the rest of us? Burgess Owens is a former NFL player. The Reverend Michael Faulkner is a candidate for New York Comptroller. Both of them once played for the New York Jets, so they're well situated to comment on this. Both join us tonight. Thank you both. Reverend, I want to go to you first and ask if you understand why this is all a little hard to take. Nobody can test the First Amendment right of these players to do what they've done, but to watch the richest, most celebrated, most pampered people in America attack not police brutality, but the country itself. Can you see why people find that so very disgusting?
Yeah, they don't know how to express their anger. And when, you know, and I push back a little bit, Tucker, on the richest, most pampered, because they've had to go through a journey to get where they are. So yeah. They've gone through some things to get where they are. They're not pampered. They weren't born of means. Many of them were born into low-income families, etc. So they've gotten where they've gotten because of their talent, their God-given ability.
However, let me stop you there. But isn't that the whole point? And you're right, of course. What you just said is totally true. But isn't that the whole point? In America, people from a low station can wind up being some of the richest and most pampered people in the country, as they are.
Absolutely. And listen, as an American, I have a responsibility to challenge power, to challenge authority. However, we're talking now about the setting of it. The setting for an NFL football game and the stars of the game kneeling down before the game is not the proper setting for them to express their political angst and their opposition to what is going on outside of in the inner cities. And
right.
it just takes away the political legs, and it's offensive. And to be honest with you, I think we ought to talk about having that conversation, talking about giving them an opportunity to do something different, because not standing for the national anthem certainly wouldn't be something I would do.
But these guys have plenty of... Look, I mean, they can say... Every word is recorded by dutiful scribes in the sports press, so it's not like they have no outlet. So, Burgess Owens, I'm wondering why the United States government should be subsidizing this. If these guys hate the government, a lot of the stadiums they play in, I would say the majority, are funded by taxpayers. The Pentagon spends hundreds of millions a year advertising at NFL games in the stadium and on broadcast. Why should they be doing that? If these guys hate America, why are American taxpayers picking up a lot of the tax?
Well, I don't think they should be with this whole process. Is what the flag stands for. When I stood on the sideline, I remember getting teary-eyed at points because I was so excited about being there, so proud to be part of that process. But I also grew up during a time when 70% of black men were mentors to us. They were in the home, doing the things they needed to do, teaching us that this country is the greatest place to be and to grow in. We now have come to a point because of liberalism, because of the process of what democratic policies do, 70% of black men do not stay around. They don't have these parents and these fathers to tell what they should be proud of and how they should stand up and for this process. So this is not a void. We're dealing with an ideology that, first of all, bans God, has destroyed the black family in the 70s, which we led the country in terms of our strength of our family unit. They have destroyed our history. No one even knows about how strong the black American history was. And now they want to take away the pride of the country. And I think it's a bridge too far. I think this is the one thing that Americans, we might disagree. Mike and I might disagree in terms of what they can do in the field, but at the end of the day, we love our country, and we're going to make sure we stand against those who take away the hope of our kids.
And that's what these liberals are doing. I think that's right. And I mean, Michael Faulkner, isn't that the whole point, that these are people who are revered by kids and
right.
by lots of Americans? And shouldn't they be, look, America's flawed, nobody argues that it's not, but that the whole enterprise is illegitimate and disgusting, which is what they're saying, and the flag is an object of contempt. Shouldn't they be telling us the opposite?
Absolutely. It's obviously true. And taking a knee, they don't get a chance to talk about their, issue. First of all, they need to get up and do something about, they need to not just protest, but they need to get up and they need to be part of the national conversation to make America better, to make their communities better, to take their responsibilities, just like Burgess was talking about. But secondly, you know, I thought about it after I looked at, again, at what Pittsburgh did. Maybe we should not allow them on the field unless they can stand in honor of the flag and the national anthem. Maybe they should be restricted from the field unless they plan to honor the flag and honor the national anthem as all the fans do in the stands.
Well, that's a great suggestion. By the way, Burgess, isn't that consistent with the way the NFL operates? I mean, if you want to wear orange socks on a team with white socks, you can't. The owner says the team says you can't. That's exactly right. Why don't they hear?
Well, let's take it a step further. The NFL corporate office right here in New York City. How about their employees on lunchtime decided they wanted to demonstrate? They'll find it. They'll come back and find out that their desks will be vacated.
Right.
And at the end of the day, this is what's happening. The liberals at the top elitists, they are using my race. They're bringing misery to my race and then using this misery to make sure they keep their power. We need to make sure, number one, there's two things. We need to make sure that we're standing against corporate elitists, liberal elitists like the NFL. I will be boycotting every single team that does this. But we also have to, as black conservatives, get into the black community and let them see what the Democratic Party has for years done to them. It's not a white American problem. It's a Democratic, black and white elitist problem.
And the third thing you need to do is run for something so I can vote for you. Unfortunately, we're out of time. Gentlemen, thank you both very much.
Thank you, Tucker. Appreciate it, buddy.